electrical meter like this, water meter like this, and gas meter like this. Actually, you only need one dashboard to rule them all. Hi, I'm Johnny from TechZen. Are you tired of juggling between different apps and websites just to check your electricity, water, and gas consumption? Imagine having all that information in one convenient place. Well, you're in luck. In this video, I will show you exactly how to consolidate all your energy data into a single, easy-to-use dashboard. Here is a summary of what I will cover. Home power meter device and integration. Whole house meter, individual device monitoring, smart water monitor and integration, natural gas meter using a template sensor, the ultimate energy dashboard for all the above. There are many power meter products out there, but I highly recommend Shelly Energy Monitor, which runs in your local network without the cloud. The Shelly EM is a whole house power meter. It requires installation at the main electrical panel. I have two channels, so Shelly EM2 works well for me. If you have three channels in your electrical panel, you will need the Shelly EM3. Install the Shelly Smart Control app to add the device to your home Wi-Fi network. Get the IP address of the Shelly EM device in the app. Now the installation is complete, and let's go to Home Assistant and add the Shelly EM device. Settings, Devices and Services, Add Integration, Shelly, input the local IP address of the Shelly EM in your home network. Once it's added, you can verify the device and sensors. The Shelly EM has sensors of two channels to monitor energy, energy return, and voltage. The Shelly EM runs in your home network and logs data to Home Assistant locally without the need of the internet. After the power meter is completed, let's see how to monitor individual devices. My approach is purchase smart Wi-Fi plugs with energy monitor features and pay attention to the following. Test mode of firmware compatibility. While Tuya and other cloud-based IoT platforms are very popular and easy to use, I still prefer using TestModa for purely locally managed devices without the cloud. Please comment below if you'd like to see another video about how to install TestModa firmware to supported devices and manage them in the Home Assistant. Amps rating. For heavy-duty electrical devices, be sure to choose a higher amps rating, or you are at risk of burning the smart plugs. Configuration of the power monitoring smart plugs are quite straightforward. Assuming you already have a working MQTT integration in Home Assistant, TestModa integration automatically generates all supported controls and sensors for you. Go to the TestModa device web portal, Configuration, Configure MQTT. Fill in the MQTT server information. Now go back to Home Assistant Devices and Services. You will find all discovered devices under the TestModa integration page. I also have Tuya integration and a bunch of Tuya devices, and TP-Link devices as well. I have a charge point level 2 home charger which provides native Home Assistant support. My solar panels come with Solar Edge inverter, and their platform also provides comprehensive integration with Home Assistant. My advice is that when you purchase electrical devices in your home, always do your research and make sure the manufacturer provides good support with Home Assist integration. Now, you have your own electricity meter as well as being able to monitor power for individual devices. Let's look at how to monitor water in your home. For a water meter, there's a simple solution using a smart water shutoff valve like the Moen Flo. Personally, I think every home should have a Moen Flo smart valve for the following reasons. Water monitoring including pressure, flow rate, temperature, and usage volumes. Prevent pipeline leak with emergency shutoff. Remote shutoff or turn on from anywhere, anytime. My Moen Flo is plugged into a compact CyberPower 255-watt UPS. This is important because you don't want the smart valve to stop working during a power outage. After the device has been initialized and joined to my home network using the Moen Flo app, adding it to a Home Assistant is easy peasy. Go to Settings, Devices and Services, Add Integration, and select Flo. Enter your credential of the Flo account, and you will have devices and entity generated for the smart water valve. There's so much stuff exposed to Home Assistant, and they are more than enough to totally replace your old dummy water meter. And once you've completed integrating the smart water meter, it's time for step 3, the natural gas meter. I don't have a smart gas meter, and I don't plan to install one due to the regulation and complexity of installation. If you have a similar situation and still like to have a rough idea of gas consumption in Home Assistant, follow the remainder of this video to create your own smart gas meter in Home Assistant. First, you need to import your traditional gas meter reading into a plain text file. There are two ways. One, download the data from your gas provider. I do this monthly from the gas provider website. The data file is a CSV file with basic info about my gas usage, like date range, gas volume, and end temperature. The second approach is the most universal one if you only have access to a paper gas bill. Just grab the meter reading in the bill and put them in a plain text file. Each line could have a date and a consumed gas volume separated by comma. Once the file is ready, upload it to Home Assistant using the file editor add-on. Next, we create a file sensor to hold the data file. Add integration. File. Set up a file-based sensor. Put in the file path. Value template. Home Assistant file integration only reads the last line of data. My consumption value is the fourth column in the CSV file. So we first split the line using a comma, then take the value at index 3. Because this is a zero-based index, unit of measurement is cubic meter. This file-based sensor now provides the last reading of your latest meter data. But we still need a template energy sensor for Home Assistant to be aware of the gas meter. Settings, Devices and Services, Helpers, Create Helper, Template, Template a Sensor. Template, states, sensor.file. state class, total increasing. After the gas meter energy sensor is created, whenever you add a new line of meter reading in your file, the value will be reflected in the gas meter sensor automatically. You can feel free to update the file manually as frequently as you like. For example, at every month end when your gas provider sends you the meter reading by mail. Now you have a smart gas meter, even if you don't have a physical smart gas meter device connected to your gas line. How nice is that? This trick also works for electricity and water as well. The only difference is the unit of measurement. We have covered so much about all different meters in home system, like electricity, water, and gas. Finally, it's the exciting part to combine them together into a beautiful energy dashboard to show off. If you follow all my previous steps, it takes only a few clicks. Settings, dashboards, energy. Simply add different sensors to the section like so. Shelly EM have both consumption sensor and return to grid sensor, which are used to calculate the solar generated electricity returned to the grid. After adding all devices, give it a couple of hours for Home Assistant to do the data mining. The Energy Dashboard is my favorite page in Home Assistant. It gives you tons of statistical information about the energy usage in my home. Much more comprehensive than any other smart meter app or utility provider web portal. When you own your data locally in Home Assistant, nothing is impossible. This is the reason why I always promote building a home automation system without the cloud. You can find my blog article in the video description below. There you have it. In just a few steps, you can combine all your energy meters, including electricity, water, and gas, into one beautiful dashboard. Don't forget to like this video, subscribe for more awesome content, and visit my blog for in-depth article and updates. Thanks for watching, and see you next time.